So here, as you can see in figure, first we will explain this one, then we will start our exercise 6.2, question number 3. Because here I will show you some easier method than the other method. So here I would like to explain you that if ST is parallel to QR is given to us. That is we already proved in converse basic proportionality that two lines are parallel. Then what we can do, and in basic proportionality also, if two lines are parallel, so we till the time we were writing that part by part, hum likh rahe the PS upon SQ, and that will be equals to PT upon TR, means part by part we were writing. Means if we are taking ratio of PS upon SQ, yani ki 2 by 4, or we are taking ratio of 6 upon 12. So answer should be same. So wahan pe answer aa raha tha 1 by 2, aur iska bhi answer aa raha tha 1 by 2. So we can say that this one is proven. Hum wahan pe bol rahe the ki ye cheez kya ho gayi hai, prove ho gayi hai. Humko isko ab aur prove karne ki zarurat nahi hai. But the new thing that I would like to tell you is that if two lines are parallel to each other, then we can take a ratio of whole by part or part by whole. So what is that? I means to say that if ST is parallel to QR is given to us, so we can take a ratio of this whole PQ. So what is that? PQ upon PS. So what is PQ upon PS? 4 plus 2, that is 6, and PS is 2. So answer will be 3. And if you are taking this whole side, means PR by PT, means answer is 18 upon 6. So answer will be 3. So here we proved that if you are taking ratio of this side, whole by part, then also the ratio will be same. So here you can see that we have proved all these things. Now here we will take our main topic, that is question number 3. In that we have to prove some ratio. So we will use this method only to prove it. So here we will begin. Here I wrote all these things. The question is given like that in a given figure. LM is parallel to CB. And LN is parallel to CD, and we have to prove AM upon AB and AN by ND should be equal. So as I told you that part by part is equals to part by part, but if we are taking whole by part and we are comparing another whole by part, that will be also equal. So we will use that and it will make our sum easier. So here in given we will write this, that LM is parallel to CB and LN is parallel to CD. And here we will see that this we have to prove. What we have to prove? AM upon AB is equals to AN upon AD. So first we will talk about, we will divide this figure into two parts. We are talking about triangle ABC first, means we are talking about this figure 1. So if we are talking about figure 1, there if LM is, this LM is parallel to this CB, so we can write, what we can write? So here we will remember that we have to take it in the form of part by whole. So what we will write, so we will see the figure as we want AB over there and AM over there. So here you just see what I am taking. So we will write in figure triangle ABC, LM is parallel to CB. So therefore we can write that AM by AB. So here we have taken AM by AB. So for this side we will take this AL upon this whole AC. So we will compare with AL by AC. And that we will give it as number 1. So here we are giving it as number 1. So now here we are talking about figure 2. In figure 2, this LN is parallel to this CD. for that again we will write in triangle. Here we are writing in triangle ADC. Now again we will take the thing that we want. Okay, so here what we will do, so here we can see that the ratio is AN upon that whole AD, and that will be equals to AL upon AC, and that will be our figure 2. So here what we can see, this AL upon AC and here also AL upon AC, that is equals to AM upon AB and AN upon AD. So directly we will compare both this and we will write our next line. And as you can see in proof 2, that if we are comparing this, this will be directly proof. Here we can see AM upon AB and AN upon AD. So here in the next page we will simply write that AM upon AB is equals to AN upon AD, and hence this one is proved. But you will ask me that here we should mention over here that how we have proved all these things. So here I would like to tell you that here we will write according to basic proportionality. So how we will write it, let me write it in proper manner. So in notebook 2 you can write it properly. Whatever I have written over here, you have to write that. Here you have to give it name as number 2 only. This one is our second equation, so you will give it name as 2, and here in bracket you have to write that BPT according to basic proportionality theorem. We have used this, so we will write in bracket. This one we have taken from basic proportionality. Then you have to write all these things in triangle ABC, in triangle ADC, and then you have to compare ratio. Now in before this you have to write compare equation 1 and 2. So we will write compare one and two. If you are comparing 1 and 2, then only we can write this thing. So you have to mention it, compare equation 1 and 2, so we can prove that AN upon AB is equals to AN upon AD by easy method. We are not adding anything and we are not